Hey guys, I'm Tanya, and for all of you who don't know me, I am an Indian student who moved to Canada to pursue her postgraduate certificate course. And this video is going to be all about housing in Toronto. So I recently moved to a new place in Toronto, and to know more about my experiences and my tips to finding a perfect place, stay tuned and keep watching. So number one, where do you start looking? So my top two suggestions would be Kijiji and Facebook Marketplace. So Kijiji is perfect if you're looking for a long-term place where you would want to be the leaseholder and you would like to have at least a year lease going on. And mostly the places in Kijiji would be unfurnished, newly renovated, because most of the listed real estate brokers are over there. Most of the owners who want tenants are over there. But if you're looking for something quick, if you do not want to get into that yearly commitment, then you would get more such deals on Facebook Marketplace, which is mostly which mostly involves students who want to sublease their place or who no longer want to stay in their place, so they want a replacement for themselves. So this would be a quicker process. It wouldn't require a lot of credit checks. It wouldn't require guarantors. So it just depends on what you are looking for. And if you have someone who you know in Canada, then I would always suggest to ask them first if they know someone who has a place to rent, because it's always good to stay in a place which you trust, with someone you trust, which leads me to my point two. So point number two is always make sure that you go and check out the place before paying the rent. If you cannot go, then just make someone you know go. If that is not possible, then at least make sure you have a video call before paying the money, because we've heard a lot about scams. You pay the money and then when you actually go, the place doesn't exist, or yeah, it's just a scam. If not that, then yeah, pictures could be deceptive. The write-ups could be beautiful, but when you actually go to stay at that place, it might not be what you expected. So this happened to me when I saw this post on Facebook Marketplace which said a spacious private bedroom for $500, and I was like, okay, that sounds really nice. And I went to the place. The pictures look nice as well, but when I went to the place, I saw that so this was the living room, and then just a small part of the living room was like a small partition, and then they had a bed over there, and the partition wouldn't even cover the whole bed, so like anyone sitting in the living room could see you, which means you have no privacy, nothing at all, no wardrobe space, nothing. So yeah, don't just get carried away by pictures. Always go and check the place out. And another thing that happened to me was the first place that I lived in, it was a private room, and I booked it from India, and I thought that, wow, okay, this is perfect. I'm getting a private room for $550, and it was great. And when I went there, I saw that the place was infested with cockroaches. So the kitchen was filled with cockroaches, my room had a few, and my days just went going around them with an insect repellent, just trying to kill them. So yeah, I couldn't do anything because I had to book a place from India, and I wish I had actually got someone to go to the place and actually look before paying the rent and confirming the deal. So number three, I would want to talk about the demand of places for rent in Toronto especially. So with so many students coming in, and this is specifically in the months of September and January, which are the two main intakes which happen in Canada, this is when places are in high demand and they go off like crazy, like they just get outlisted. And this happened to me. So I when I was moving from India to Canada, I found a really nice place close to my college. It was a private room for say 600 or something, and I really liked the place, but I was like, okay, let me do my research, let me wait a little, and then I could confirm this deal. The place is not going anywhere. And just the next day when I called the person to confirm the deal, he was like, oh, the place is gone. So yeah, there are a lot of situations when the place gets listed and within an hour someone just buys it. Someone just rents it. So I would say don't take a haste decision, but if you have found your perfect place, then just go ahead and confirm the deal, because places, just people want places, and it's in high demand. So let's talk about types of houses that you can find in Canada. So the most popular ones would be apartments, houses, and condos. and another fourth one would be student housings. So apartments are basically like what we have in India, where you have a building with a few houses, and yeah, they don't really have amenities. It's just like a building with houses, and yeah, that would be it. So a condo is somewhat a more posh kind of an apartment, where you have sky rises with a lot of facilities like gyms, swimming pools. They are usually the expensive ones. And then the third are houses. So houses are the typical houses that we have seen in movies, where you have like a basement, you have a floor, you have the ground floor, you have the top floor, and yeah, with it has a beautiful backyard and stuff like that. So yeah, and then student housing are mainly houses which have been converted into small rooms so that they could accommodate a lot of students in them. So I used to stay in an apartment before, and now I have moved to this house with a beautiful backyard here. And I know it looks really fancy, but it comes with a lot of work. So this grass over here, we need to mow it every week, and we need to put out garbage every Tuesday, because that is when the garbage truck comes. So yeah, it's a lot of work, but it's still fun. And yeah, another thing, during winter days, I'm sure it would be us who would be shoving off all of the snow from our walkway. So it's fun, but it's some work. So that is about houses. And I have a lot of friends who are staying in student housing. So if you're looking for a private room and you are on a budget, then you can go for a student house. The only problem with most of these houses are that you don't really get a living room, so you don't have a living space as much. You just have a private room, a room to yourself, and that's it. So for someone who likes to go around and who likes to have a lot of space, it would be a little boring for them to be trapped in their room the whole time. And most of the times when you stay in a place like that, you don't know who you stay with. You're not really close friends with the people staying in your apartment. So it gets a little lonely sometimes, especially my friends shared their experiences during this quarantine that we had, and it got really lonely for them. Whereas with me staying in a house, I know everyone who stays in my place, and we are all good friends. So it's kind of fun, you know, you have people around you, it's always entertaining. And yeah, so that also brings me to another point. Do you want a private room, or do you want to have a sharing room? So it all depends on you, honestly. It all depends on the kind of person you are. So I have been staying in a sharing room, and it's been pretty good for me so far, honestly. I like having someone around me, and yeah, I guess I would have gotten pretty bored having a private room. So my suggestion would be, even if you want to have a private room, a room to yourself, at least have it in a house where you know people, so that when you get bored or when you actually feel a little lonely and you want someone to talk to, you have someone. So yeah, and another thing that I would talk about is, it again depends on you. So for me, I am not a person who likes to travel a lot. So for me, my first point was to stay near college. It is always that places near the college are expensive compared to apartments or houses which are a little away from college. So it all depends on you. If you're okay with traveling, then definitely you can find a much cheaper place away from college. And if you want to stay close to college, then yeah, you'll have to pay the price, or you would have to be okay with sharing the place with more people, or settling in for like an average house. Which also brings me to talking about transit. So if you are planning to move to a place away from college, then make sure that you would have to pay the fare, the transit fare, which is not the cheapest that we have here in Toronto. So public transport is pretty expensive over here. And if you're planning to buy a monthly pass, the monthly TTC pass, then it would be around $150 approximately for a month. So yeah, add that to your budget if you are planning to move away. If you're planning to move to Mississauga, Brampton, or yeah, somewhere away from the GTA, then you would have to pay two transit fares. So I know people who would stay in Mississauga, and they would first take the MyWay, pay the transit fare over there, and then pay the TTC fare as well. So yeah, do add that to your budget if you're planning to do so. and then decide what makes more sense to you. Okay, so let's talk about utilities. So you will see a lot of postings which would say a room available for $500 and hydro extra, hydro exclusive, or exclusive of hydro, or utilities exclusive. So basically what hydro means in Canada is the electricity. So what this post means to say is that this is your room for $500, and then whatever the electricity bill would be, you would have to pay a share of it. So yeah, do add that to your budget as well. The average budget for the average cost of utility is usually say $20 to $25 per person, but it all depends on your usage, what you have, and what you use, what you have. So like if you have a laundry in your in-suite, if you have a laundry in your apartment, then yeah, your utilities would definitely be more. Utilities are usually high in winters because you use your heater a lot. So yeah, and so make sure when you see an apartment, see what kind of a heater they have, because the last apartment that I stayed in had a baseboard heater, which means that the electricity bill would shoot up like crazy. So when everyone else used to be paying $20 per person, we would be paying $60 per person because we had a baseboard heater, which is a new technology, a modern technology, which is really convenient, but then expensive too. So make sure what kind of technology you have in your house, because that makes a huge difference. Also, talking about laundry. So if you have a laundry in your house, nothing like it, that's the best thing. That's really convenient. If not, then you have laundry rooms where you have to go and get your clothes washed. So again, it all depends on what you like and what is convenient to you. If you have a laundry in your own house, then it's much more convenient, but yeah, you pay for it in the utilities. So yeah, I would always prefer to have a laundry in my house. It just makes things convenient. So what next after you are done finding your perfect house and you want to move in? So once you are done with the whole process of finding your house and they agree to have you in that place and you pay the rent, usually what you would do is you would pay the first month and you would pay the last month rent. So if you have a 1 year lease, then July is your first month, and then the next year, June, would be your last month. So you pay it as a deposit so that they know that you wouldn't just leave the place just like that. And if you're not going under a lease, if you're not in a proper lease, then you might just have to pay the rent month-to-month basis, or they would still take the last month, and whenever you give them a notice, they would consider that to be your last month. And yeah, when you are done with all of that process and you finally want to move into the place, if you're coming from anywhere international, then yeah, just pack your suitcases and you can move in right away and just buy the necessary things that you need if your place is unfurnished, like buy a mattress, buy a study table if you need, buy a fan if you're moving in summer and you don't have an air conditioner. Yes, it is hot in Canada. Canadian summers are really hot. I didn't expect it to be so hot, but yeah, that is what it is. So Canada treats you with extreme weathers. So freezing cold in the winters and scorching heat in summers. So be prepared for that. And if you're just switching places, if you're switching from one house in Canada to another, then depending on your luggage, you decide how you wanna do the moving process. So with me, I had a lot of luggage that I needed to bring with me from my previous house to this house, because I had a bed, I had some furniture. So we decided to book a U-Haul. It would be advisable to book a U-Haul where you can drive on your own. So you drive your U-Haul, that just makes it much cheaper. And so I had a friend who knew how to drive. So yeah, just take someone's help for that, and that's your moving process. It is a little tedious. It was really exhausting, but it's not too bad. And it's always a fun experience to move to a new place. And as much as I miss my old house, I really enjoy being in this new place, in this new atmosphere. And everyone needs a change in their life, right? So this was all about today's video, and if you have any more questions, then just shoot it in the comment section below and I will make sure I answer them. And I hope you found this video informative and enjoyed it. If you did, then do not forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching guys, and see you again soon. Bye.